After that, identification and nomenclature. For example, we know that plants and animals in our own area, by it means in our surroundings, by their local names. We know that plants and animals in our own area, okay? So, in our surroundings, by their local names. For example, plants, animals are known by local names. Our surrounding area. Okay, but so these areas are different from one place to the another places. The local names are also different. So it means one area having that one local name, another area having that another local name. So that is leads to that lot of confusion. We cannot easily identify that plants, because so different areas having that different local names to that plants. That's why, so it is requirement, it is a need. It means a different properties, so a defining naming system is needed to that naming to the plants, right? So different it means plants and animals are known by local names, our surrounding area. These areas are different from one region to that another region, from one country to that another country. So it is leads to that lot of confusion. So that it means it is necessary, it means to identify the plants. So it means a standardizing naming system is necessary, okay, for identification to that plants, right? So it means providing a correctable, suitable name to that identified plant is known as that nomenclature. What is the meaning of nomenclature? Nomenclature means providing a correct suitable name to identified organism, to identified organism. So nomenclature means providing a correct suitable name to identified organism, okay? So that is known as the nomenclature. Nomenclature is possible. When it is a possible, it is important bit. Nomenclature is possible only if identified organism is correctly identified. Okay, this identified organism is correctly described and correctly, accurately identified. Okay, only that nomenclature is available. Okay, it is possible. Nomenclature is possible only the identified organism is correctly described and accurately identified, right? So that is known as that nomenclature. So after that, what is the meaning of that identification process? After that identification, what is the definition of identification? So whether a collected name is, whether an identified organism is entirely new or it is also known. The collected plant is completely, entirely means, the collected plant is entirely new, or it is also known. Okay, that is known as that identification. Whether the collected plant is entirely new or it is also known as identification. Generally, identification directly takes place by authentic herbarium. Authentic herbarium means what is the meaning? So it is agreed, it is accepted by that all scientists. So that is known as authentic herbarium. Which herbarium is accepted by that all scientists by the worldwide? So that is known as authentic herbarium or specimen. Authentic herbarium or specimen. Authentic herbarium or a specimen. It is a directly. So indirectly, identification is takes place indirectly by keys in floras. Right, indirectly keys in floras. I will explain the what is the meaning of floras and keys. Okay, so that is known as that identification process. Okay, after that biologist established certain, it means, procedures and criteria for naming to that plants. Okay, so biologists have established certain rules and criteria based on universally accepted system. So based on universally accepted system, that is known as an ICBN. Based on ICBN. So ICBN means, what is the meaning? International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. So ICBN provide scientific names or biological names, okay, to that plants. Okay, so it is agreed by that all scientists. So that is known as universally accepted system. It is universally accepted system. It is a universally accepted system of classification. So it is a universally accepted system. According to this rule, all living, each plant having that one scientific name, so our biological name. So these organisms are known throughout the worldwide by the same biological name or a scientific name. This biological name or scientific name is not due to that other organism. So each organism having only one biological name, so it is not used to that other organism, right? So it is a important point. According to that ICBN rules, so it is accepted by that all the biologists, and all the biologists are followed by these rules, right? For example, for the first time in ICBN, rules are provided by that Carolus von Linnaeus. ICBN rules provided by Carolus von Linnaeus scientist. Carolus von Linnaeus scientist. Remaining other biologists are followed this criteria and rules of ICBN. For example, he explained that, so in that biological name, so that is known as that Mangifera indica. In Mangifera indica, first word is indicated the genus, second word is indicated that species. It is a biological name of that mango. It is a biological name of that
mango. Okay,
right. After that, binomial nomenclature. According to that binomial nomenclature, so each plant having that suitable scientific name, so this scientific name having, so naming to the plants with the two components, each plant having that scientific name, each plant with having with the scientific name with the two components. Okay, so the first word indicate the genus, second word indicate the species, that is known as that binomial nomenclature. Providing naming to the plants with the two components or two words, that is known as that binomial nomenclature. So in binomial nomenclature, first word is indicated the genus, second word is indicated that species. For example, so in the biological name, so it is that Mangifera indica. So in that Mangifera indica, first word indicated that genus, second word indicated that species. Okay, so they are always written in okay, so it is present in the Latin language. It is present in a Latin language or written in italics. Written in italics. So italics means just like that Mangifera. Mangifera indica. So that is known as written in italics, is cross lines. Okay. So after that, if genus and species, okay, handwritten separately or underlined. For example, Mangifera, it is a genus, it is a species. Handwritten separately, underlined. Okay. So after that, for example, in genus and species, so genus always start with capital letter. So it is a capital letter. Species is always start with small letters. It is a capital letter. It is known as that small letters. Right? So after that, for example, between that genus and species, between that genus and species, it is a genus, it is a species. Between genus and species, not use that any punctuation letters. It means polystern, comma. So any, okay, it means letters are not used between that genus and species. So next point, so genus is always, okay, in present in that noun form. Genus is always present noun form. Species is indicated that adjective. Species is indicate that adjective form. Right? Which scientist providing scientific name to the plants? So he was considered as author. He was considered as a author. So that is known as author of citation. So the scientific names are given abbreviation form at the end of scientific name. For example, if Mangifera indica is name is given by that Linnaeus, so in the abbreviation form it is a Lin. So it is known as author of a citation, or indicated that L, just like that. Okay, L indicate that Linnaeus, right? So these are some rules of binomial nomenclature. Okay. Next, after the nomenclature, classification. It means we cannot easily study and understanding all living organisms on there, because different organisms are there. So it is possible when it is classified or divide. Only it is possible only it is possible when it is a device or classify. It means, so for study and understanding of living organism, plants are compulsory divide or classified. Living organisms are classified. When living organisms are classified, we can easily study and understanding. That's why that is known as that classification. So what is the definition of the classification? Anything is grouped into convenient categories. Convenient categories. Anything is grouped into convenient categories. So that is known as that classification. Okay. So based on some easily observed characters. Based on some easily observable characters. Right? Anything is grouped into convenient categories based on some easily observable characters. So that is known as that classification. Based on some easily observable characters, plants are divided into different categories. Okay? Conveniently. So that is known as that category. Category means So based on that, some easily convenient categories can mean some classes or groups. Okay, so some easy observable characters, that is known as that classification. It means living organisms are easily understand and studying only if they are classified. So it means classification is necessary for study and understanding of a living organism. Anything is grouped into convenient categories based on some easily observable characters, that is known as the classification. Okay, each group is known as that category. Okay, so it means plants or living organisms are divided into different groups. Different groups is known as the taxa. Different groups is known as that taxa. Okay, so living organisms are divided into different taxa, that is known as that taxonomy. Okay, after that taxonomy. Taxonomy means living organisms divided into different taxa based on characteristics. Based on characteristics. So that is known as that taxonomy. Okay, it means, for example, cat, dog, wheat, rice. So this all are that different taxa. So we can easily identify that by that. Okay, so is divided into different taxa based on that categories, that is known as that classification. After that, basic components of taxonomy. So what are the basic components of taxonomy? Identification, second one is the nomenclature, classification, First one is a characterization. Characterization, identification, nomenclature, and classification. So this four, okay? So it means the factors are involved in the taxonomy. They are that considered as basic components. Basic components of taxonomy, right? So it means taxonomy, it means it means taxes or plants are divided into different groups, okay, based on that characters. It means classification is required. Classification is that hierarchical steps. Classification is hierarchical steps. Classification is hierarchical steps in taxonomy. Right? Each step in classification is known as a taxon. Each step in classification. Each step in classification is known as taxon. Each step in classification is known as that taxon or rank. Right? So classification is present in the hierarchy level of steps. So in the hierarchy level of steps is known as that classification process. So in the classification, for example, you take that first one is that division. Kingdom, division, class, order, family, genus, after then species. After then species process. So for example, each step is also known as the taxon. For example, you take that highest taxon is a kingdom. In classification, it is at a highest taxon. Next, species is the lowest taxon. Species is lowest taxon. Species is lowest taxon. Next, kingdom is the highest taxon. Right? So, that is known as the species and kingdom. Right? After that, from it means they are having that different type of the category. In that, what is the first category? First one is that species. It is that species.